So the first sports bike experience provided to the Indian masses, the Bajaj Pulsar. Now, if you ask about a Pulsar to the Indian masses, everyone knows about it. It's an emotion that the brand has built up over the years. What Pulsar stands for is fun and the involving riding experience.
That said, more than anything, the Pulsar became a motorcycle icon for the youth. And within no time, it started setting the sales charts on fire. Fast forward to today, after 20 years of its inception, the Pulsar range is still going strong, which in itself shows how much the Indians are in love with the brand. And after 2 decades of the launch of the first Pulsar and 1 after the launch of the NS200, Bajaj have finally given us the brand new Pulsar N250.
So after riding at the track, I think it's justified to say that the Pulsars have just blown me away. Like, the engine is like, it doesn't feel like a Bajaj or the typical Pulsars we knew. It's bloody refined, there's ample of power, the torque's available throughout the rev range. And well, before the keyboard warriors start typing in the comments down below that it doesn't have a 6-speed gearbox and all that, the 5-speed gearbox is more than sufficient. Like, it was easy to corner on the track, the top speed was easily achievable, and it was very easy to maintain the speed throughout the track, even after having the 5-speed gearbox. The gear ratios are so well balancedly put that you don't need a 6-gear, like, you have to ride it to believe it. So, well, on the handling department, Bajaj has worked on a completely new chassis, which is 3 kilos lighter than the perimeter frame available at the NS200, and it's also stiffer. Now, well, on the track, that shows. This bike is so agile, it's so easy to handle. Like, it's just an easy bike to ride overall. Like, after a few laps, you will realize that you're scraping the foot pegs in no time. It's that easy to ride fast around the track. If that doesn't explain it, I have no idea what will, because the steering is just spot on. The rider's triangle, it's not too aggressive, but it's not too relaxed. It lets you go fast, or it lets you sit comfortably and go the distance. Like, it does the job quite perfectly. The seats are well cushioned. And talking about the engine, it makes 24.5 bhp and 21.5 newton meters of torque. That is almost the same as the NS200 and has more torque than the NS200. Now again, no 6-gear, in 5 gears it gives everything earlier and or as much or if not more than the NS200, and that works really well over here on the track. And we did grow and run around in the city. The clutch is effortless, it's so light, the gear shifts are so slick. I think it's safe to say this is the most refined and easy to ride Pulsar till date, and I think Bajaj have hit the nail spot on the head with the engine over here. I think the ideology what they had is to have the Pulsar experience more than setting the bike into the segment has played out really well for them, because this engine is really good. You want to commute, you want to go through the highway, or even take it to a fun racetrack like here. Like, it performs and there is no gripe. And the fuel economy, well, Bajaj claims 39 kmpl, even if we get around 35 or 30, no complaints. So overall, I think this is a very well put bike. It's a very balanced bike. Well, it does something very rare that most bikes fail to do right now in this age and time, that is, it does everything decently well. You want to commute, it's easy. You can ride as low as 25 km per hour in fourth gear, no issues whatsoever. You want to ring it on the track, you can ring it on the track. On highways, around 80, 90, 100 kmph, it feels, well, it just floats on. And then it's fuel efficient, it's spacious, it handles well. If all this isn't what makes you buy this bike, I have no idea what will. So that's about it from my end. I'll be handing it over to my newbie boss, who almost died today, but he's alive. So off to him.
Thanks, Kiran, for the very warm welcome. Yes, I was about to die, but I would like to say that was because of the bike and totally not me. Just kidding. The N250 is one of the most balanced motorcycles we have ever tested. And after riding this motorcycle for the better part of over 2 to 3 hours, these are some of my observations.
Now, Bajaj has focused a lot on the rider's triangle, as some people would say, to make this bike as comfortable as possible. So instead of having a 0-degree angle on the engine, they've offset the engine 10 degrees so that you can have the best seating position possible. And since we Indians are, well, vertically challenged, some would say, the seat height is a very comfortable and very accessible 795 mm. And while riding it, you don't feel like you're on top of the bike, but you feel rather that you're with the bike and you're part of the whole bike. It's a very communicative bike. That being said, the chassis is also completely different. And more importantly, the engine is now a stress member of the chassis. So the engine also plays a part in the rigidity of the whole bike. And all of that comes around to the refinement of the bike. So now, since the engine is a stress member of the chassis, you can't have rubber mounts and a lot of other things here and there to mute down the vibrations that the engine makes. So the refinement that Bajaj have done to this bike is absolutely amazing. I mean, of course, when you start ringing the bike out all the way up to its red line, like Kiran has done in this video, that's when the vibrations creep in. But before that, till 7000 RPM, this thing is as smooth as butter. More importantly, the handlebars are different to the F250. It's a little bit more of an aggressive riding style, but that is something that most Pulsar riders will really like, because it's a much more engaging bike than the F250, I would say. The F250 smoothens out a lot of the bumps. It's not that communicative, whereas this thing is a proper hoot. So overall, we think that the bike is a very good all-rounder. It's very versatile in that sense. It's a hoot to drive on the track. It's a great commuter on the road. The suspension is pretty comfortable. The seat is very comfortable. And the engine is a very talky motor. So in all of that sense, it's a very versatile bike. It does all of the jobs very, very well. So if you're in the market to get a new 250cc motorcycle, but you don't want to go for the Duke or even the Dominar, this is cheaper and it's more or less as good as those two. So check out the N250. Thank you so much for watching this video. Go check out Throttle Store. Use the code TDH15 to get 15% off on all merchandise. Go check that out right now. This has been Soham Saraf and Kiran. And we'll see you in the next one.
Ciao.